We'll be talking about the methodology and design of the first total diet study in Riyadh, Saudi Arabia, by Lama Almaiman. I hope I pronounced that right. Okay.
We need to keep pushing.
Hello. Thank you for the introduction. I am excited today to present the first total diet study conducted by Saudi Food and Drug Authority. In my presentation today, I will talk about the objectives of the total diet study. And I will talk about the methodology for selection of foods and analytes in the study. I'm going to also talk about the timeline and limitations of the first total diet study. We have two objectives for the Saudi total diet study. The first one is to obtain more accurate data on dietary exposure to contaminants and nutrients intake. The second one is to share data with the WHO to be used for international risk assessment committees like JICFA and JMPR. And how we're going to do that is by purchasing the most consumed foods from food retail outlets and preparing the foods as consumed, pooling and homogenizing into composites and chemical analysis. Today I'm going to talk about the selection of food criteria and analyte selection criteria and sampling preparation and SOPs. For food selection, we used food consumption data from a national survey titled The Nutritional Evaluation of the Nutritional Status of the People of Saudi Arabia, conducted in the 80s. They used the methods for dietary survey were food frequency questionnaires and 24-hour dietary recall. The targeted age group for the Saudi total diet study is 18 and above. And these are some pictures of the questionnaires used, some of them in Arabic written, for the questionnaires used in the dietary survey. For food selection criteria, we included foods that are consumed 90% of the population diet. Foods must be significant contributors to targeted analytes and must have validated analytical method at the Saudi FDA labs. And for selection of brands, we used Euromonitor market share data. And for some foods like fruits and vegetables and meat products and fish products, we used the Saudi Authority of Statistics data on import and produce. With this criteria, we had 121 food items from the food list, which are from 16 food groups and 43 subgroups. Each food item was sampled 12 times. So the total samples we purchased was 1,452 samples. For analyte selection criteria, we used SFDA risk profiles. After that, we saw if the contaminant or nutrient present in significant part of the Saudi diet, the availability of validated analytical method at SFDA labs, and also to fill gaps in knowledge regarding the nutrient or contaminant. The final list was the heavy metals, arsenic, lead, cadmium, and mercury, and also aluminium, and for nutrients, potassium, sodium, and iron. As for sampling, sampling of foods was conducted over a period of 4 months. Only one season was covered. All sampling was conducted by FDA staff, by us, by the team of the total diet study. And also sampling took place only in one city, Riyadh City, the capital of Saudi Arabia. Riyadh is a big city, is the largest city in Saudi Arabia. It is estimated that the population of Riyadh is 8 million people, which represent 27% of the total Saudi population. Four major retail markets were chosen for sampling, and they were distributed around four regions in Riyadh, north and south, east and west. For food preparation and recipes, we developed in-house standardized recipes for the food items in the TDS. The recipes were developed using three different sources of cooking books and internet websites. Household measures were converted to corresponding gram weights. All recipes were reviewed by professional Saudi chefs, and adjustments were made if appropriate to the study. This is a screenshot of one of the recipes. It's for chicken kabsa. It's rice with chicken. With directions to the chefs to include all the ingredients. After preparation, after cooking, the sample preparation, as I said, 12 samples of food, each food item were purchased. Samples were grouped into three composites to minimize the dilution effects and make the traceability of samples, of contaminated samples, very easy. Mixing and homogenizing of samples was done at SFDA labs. And here are pictures of the samples prepared for the laboratory to mix and homogenize. Before we started the TDS, we developed in-house standard operation procedures using the WHO guidance document and the total diet study book. And I would like to send a special thanks to Philip, who helped us during the phase of developing SOPs. We developed SOPs for food collection and registration, labeling and coding and storing. Also, we developed general SOPs for staff in the kitchen, including food collection and logging, and general hygiene in the kitchen, and cooking procedures, and chemical analysis. We used the SFDA classification system to code the samples, which is basically based on the Codex food classification system. Here is a picture of the collection report. So it includes the food items, sample code, and the brand name, and the store location, and the country of origin for some samples. This is to track and trace the samples with the LIMS code for the laboratory, and track if the samples are already analyzed or not. For food preparation, here are some pictures of the preparation. We contracted two professional chefs to work at SFDA kitchen. So the proposal of the study and the planning was started in 2019. After that, we started preparing the SOPs alongside with building a database. Now we are in the phase of fieldwork, food preparation and chemical analysis. And the last phase of the TDS is the data analysis and the report. And hopefully in the end of this year and next year, it's going to be ready for publication. And we will share it with you. So limitations to our study that it was conducted in one city and over one period, no seasonal or regional variations were taken into account due to budget and small staff number. And in the future, we would extend the TDS timeline, include more cities, analytes, and more seasons. Use food list from recent diet surveys, and finally establish a technical international committee to for the TDS project. That's all I have for today. Thank you all for listening on site and online, and I would like to thank the BFR and WHO for organizing this event and allowing us to share the Saudi experience in TDS.